So, Abbe, tell me what this disagreement with the Senate Judiciary Committee boils down to for you.
You know, the committee investigations, unfortunately, are devolving into political gotcha games. If committees selectively leak parts of interviews or send me letters through the media or turn Jared Kushner's very clear email that there should be no contacts with anybody in a foreign country into what they call as a missing document, then they're undermining their own credibility. You know, the issue of Russia interference in the 2016 election is a serious one, but these committee actions are not.
So what I hear you saying is that you don't believe that there's any missing documents and you don't really plan to provide any additional documents.
Now let me be clear that what we told the Judiciary Committee is that we'd send them what we had already sent the intelligence committees and then we'd work with them if there was anything else that was relevant. And then what they decided to do was to create a media event. That undermines the seriousness of their endeavor.
So do you not plan to allow another interview with the Senate Judiciary Committee? That seems to be what they're asking for.
Mr. Kushner has been very clear that he will cooperate, as he has been, voluntarily with all bipartisan requests from committees on anything that's relevant. He's done it, and he'll do it again.
So in these cases, as you know, the perception is often as important as the facts. And the perception that has been built here is that Jared Kushner perhaps has something to hide because these committees say that he's not being as forthcoming as others have been. They received the same request, the same broad request for documents, and they provided documents that Jared Kushner did not provide. Is there a problem with Jared Kushner's ability to...
Right. In my communications with the Senate Judiciary Committee, I said, take these documents and let's talk about what else is relevant. They jumped the gun to make a media event. And any perception that Mr. Kushner has been anything but not only cooperative, but if you look at the contents of these emails, he's the hero. He's the one who's saying there shouldn't be any contacts with foreign officials or foreign entities. That's what the Senate Judiciary Committee should pay attention to and not create some sort of partisan gotcha game.
The perception, though, is built because of the SF-86, the fact that he didn't disclose all those contacts at first, and the fact that these documents they say are missing that were provided by others.
Now, so when again, you say that he did not disclose on his SF-86, again, a misperception. It was sent first time with a hit of a send button before it was complete. And then within days and weeks, it was completed. I mean, that's just silliness.
It took a couple of months for the 100 the 100 additional contacts to be...
It took a couple of months to get it thorough and also make sure that it was complete. That's not atypical in this process.
So you have a deadlock jury in New Jersey that basically allowed your client to walk away from these charges in the Justice Department charges. What do you think, what's your message that you have to the department as they face a lot of pressure to retry Senator Menendez?
Look, everyone should pay very close attention to what the jurors were saying with their votes and with their words. And what they were saying is that the premise, the entire premise of the government's, all of their charges were wrong, that there was no bribery, no corrupt agreement, and that Senator Menendez and Dr. Sal Melgen were real friends. And more investigations and more prosecution and more trials cannot change that basic and simple fact.
Senator Menendez obviously is a public official. He's a policymaker. Do you think that there's reason for him to worry that there's that he adds to the cynicism that people have about the institutions? You know, the fact is that, you know, Richard Painter, the former ethics lawyer in the George W. Bush administration, said thanks to the U.S. Supreme Court for so narrowly defining bribery that convictions are almost impossible. The idea being that because of the 2016 Supreme Court ruling, Senator Menendez and other public officials are going to skate by.
I'm sorry that Mr. Painter didn't really pay attention to the trial and to the evidence and what the jurors said. They're not talking about anything like the Supreme Court's decision. What they said was the premise of the government's charges were not correct. And the premise was, they said, there was no underlying bribery, no corruption, no agreement, and that this was a real friendship. That's innocence before the Supreme Court ruled, and it's innocence after the Supreme Court ruled.